playtest happy, are we, John? Hey, boy, how's it going? You could say that, I suppose. Although, in this case, it was more like my previous stream was cut off a quarter of an hour into the intended casual playtesting session. I did say I'd come back to doing these maps, of which I got about a minute into them, which is exactly what I'm going to do right now. So, hello everyone. And boy, how are you? So, this time there should hopefully be no interruption of that kind. And I should be able to actually play these in relative peace. Look. So, these are a set of maps by bemused_1. There's two of them. One of them is a slaughter map, the second one, so it could take a little while. And if I have time after this, I may also playtest someone else's thing as well. I wish I was more playtest happy, to be honest. Because it seems like there's always someone wanting a playtest thing, but alas, with my current work and a general lifestyle, I can't really commit to being a super regular playtester. However, in the future, I would like to become someone who does a lot of regular playtesting of people's content, you know. But that will have to happen in the future, maybe next year sometime. Alright, so now, hopefully Bemused One himself will return to the chat, see this actual playthrough of his maps. So here we go, let's take a look at Bemused One's maps. So this is the first map, 510 enemies in it. Kind of have an unusual start here. You know, aside from the fact we can actually see the exit right at the beginning of the level, we can also grab some of these goodies as well. Are you sure I was able to grab the berserk? Yeah. Don't want the berserk actually, but we'll take it. So you can see that the rest of the map looks a bit like this. I'm sort of seeing some, just by judging by the auto map, I'm already seeing some sort of newbie mapper type architecture. Should be fun. Hey, Ian Mutt, how's it going? Oh, nobody tell Ian Mutt that I'm missing his deadline for Nova 3. Because I already told him I've missed the deadline for Nova 3. I told him I wasn't going to be able to make it. An interesting choice of a door texture there. Does it kind of fit to this scrolling wall, though? Wait, what should I call this one? We'll call this Bemused. Oh no. We're dropping into a pit. This doesn't bode well for me. Maybe. Well, maybe it will be okay. Window out to some. That's whiting over there. Wow, lots of ammo at the start here. Which is good. No, I have no map to send you, Ian Mutt. In fact, I need to get on with those mapping streams. I have no map at all for send. I'm even saying to Fred that I'm not gonna be able to make the deadline. I have started at a possible Nova 3 entry, but I'm really kind of undecided at what I'm gonna do at the moment. Oh god. Well, that's the plan. I will probably get down and knuckle in on focusing on making a map at some point. So, I will knuckle down and do some more mapping streams. I wonder if I should do that, like, after I finish this or something. Oh, shit. Oh, that very nearly caught me there. That was very close to being quite an effective pinky trap. Quite good. Wow. That was a rush of pinkies, alright. Anyway, I'm also compiling something. Compiling something else very special, and you may or may not have something for everyone to play tonight or tomorrow night, huh? Sounds interesting. I wonder what it could be. Actually, I genuinely don't know. Very nearly a very successful pinky rush there. Like, the pinkies would have kind of cornered me all the way out here, which would have been interesting. But, not to be. Let's see. Ow. Oh, Jesus. Good old backpack. Not a bad start to the level so far. Can we be able to re-raise this? Oh. He actually does have it so it re-raises up. That's very handy. Just gonna go back. No, not that much to get. There's some plasma though. Hmm. Just gonna use the lift in this way. Ah! Secret. Oh, I see. The light earlier indicates where it can be dropped. That's handy. So you didn't forget to have a repeatable there, which is quite good. But yeah, this is not a bad start so far. Oh boy, super shotgun. Simon even. Well, I look forward to this something else special, and whatever it is. Wow, it's been a lot of time with these almost tessellated style combos here. Interesting lift. So, a reminder, this is Bemuse.1's first foray into map making, so we are judging another newbie effort here of sorts. This is some slight oddness of the textures here. I don't know what it is, but it's a little. Yeah, there seems to be a slight texture this alteration. Only very slight. Hey, MTX996, thanks for the host. And yeah, this is the Bemused Map Boy Edition, the one where I don't get into the corner. Thank God we came out of there. These other ones have taken a while to kill. Seems to be panning out the weapons in this part with the weapons in mind for them. Didn't take a single hit for that fight though. We do hear a cyber demon. So. I'm gonna assume that is a deliberate choice of his to have the cyber demon be heard there. Oh, very deliberate. Because now he puts them into the area. I'd have kept those imps alive if I know a cyber was going to be next. I thought he might be using that to sell something else. I didn't realize he'd have a cyber like this. I don't know, man. This is kind of... Well... I suppose if a player wants to rush this encounter with the imps, giving them something to... Hey, Rifle Marine, how's it going? Scratch one cyber. Ah, shit, I can't. Alright. Ooh. Eek. Ah, I saw that. Gotcha. I've got a mega spear plus rockets now. Alright, is there a switch behind here? Can't go through that door. I pressed on them before. Quite a cunning. I didn't even notice there was a secret to be had there. I assume I will have done something in the back area. Hey, Yugi Boy 85, how's it going? So what's I set up here then? You do something in the... Ah, this area is now open. Nice. It's rather glowing lights and acidic waste. And Magnus. Of course. Oh shit, that's not good. Is the mapper of this in the chat? He hasn't revealed himself at the moment. And I haven't planned this out in advance or anything, so we'll just have to hope he shows up. Just before I even take the yellow key. Oh, that's mean. That is so mean, having all the pools lower like that. Oh, well, he gives a radiation suit, I suppose. Okay, we'll escape, and a radiation suit to use for after as well. Hey, Lance Charlson, how's it going? You are mapping for dump 3. Oh, you kind of have to use the lift here. I just realized you can't actually escape from this without using the lift. So even if you wanted to just run across and do like a crowd surf, you actually can't, so... He's kind of made sure to very tightly regulate that approach. So no cheap get out of the imp trap for you. This thing dropped there. Had a specter in place. And now we're in Crate City. TNT crates and all. So John, would you be interested in playing the level I'm making for Mega Blast 98's map pack? Well, I'll see if I have time after I've beaten these two maps, MTX, because the second of these maps is a slaughter map, so it could take a while. If I have time after I've beaten those two, then sure, I might play that, yeah. But I need to be getting... But after I've done this... Hey, Say Wolfroo, how's it going? But after I've done this, I need to be getting on with the Doomworld Megawad Corp project of the month. Yep, Ancient Aliens. It was picked, to no great surprise. I mean, I voted for it, so... So, I'll be playing Ancient Aliens next up as a Doom thing. Probably play that on... I think I'll be playing that on Friday, actually. Oh yeah, I turned off the caps lock thing, didn't I? In the options. So not to worry about that anymore. How goddamn convenient. Oh yeah, Berserk. Smack. It just occurred to me that I do actually have Berserk from the start of the level. Perhaps I should use it. A little bit. May not this much though. Oh, calm down. Oh god, how far is that thing gonna fly? Oh, that's gonna be really annoying. I'm not entirely sure how to place a caca demon in this. Unless you deliberately wanted it to come right. That's alright, I guess. I guess you gotta be careful having caca demons in an area like this, and they just fly off and start sniping the player from them, although it could be a constitute a bit cheap. Oh, you don't mean today, you only got the first room done. Well, I might be in the future, MTX, sure. It's not, if you, especially if it's not going to be a very long thing. This music sounds semi-familiar. Oh boy, it's a crate with legs. Yep. And just for good measure, it's a damaged crate with legs. As a little bonus. Uh-oh. Things are about to get a little light. Oh, what? He has an arch vial. I don't include this baron usage, because this baron usage is not particularly welcome. No. This baron usage is lame. Not liking this at all. I mean, I get the idea is to keep the player busy while the player has to get around them to get to the fucking arch vial, but still don't like it. Oof. Why did it have to be just barons? Couldn't Hell Knights have done the trick? Also, I'm glad that we've got the default normal light thing instead of that infrared stuff. That's kind of a relief. Alright, where's Mr. Archie? Further back. Oh, okay, that's cool, you boy. Hey, Draken, how's it going? Good to see you around. Ah, now, where's the arch valve at? Here it is. Oh, fucking hell. I can take a hit then. Ah, now we're back at the start. I bet we can bonk ourselves on this and get ourselves a little bit of a bonus here. Yes, we can. There was even a regular armor there. Placing the regular armor. Oh wait, that's from the drop at the start of the level, isn't it? Not exactly. I was gonna say, is the blue armor really situated in a place that's more of a secret than the actual blue armor? But then it's like, no, not really. That'll do for health. He's used this crate room pretty well. I think the staircase to go back as well is pretty sweet. So I was thinking a fair bit of backtracking though. I'll be working while I finish up your science exam. There's definitely a texture glitch there or something. Alright. Now we have to go back into the radioactive goop. Good thing I actually saved that from earlier. Now we can enter this room and open this door without problem. Oh. Ooh, wow, lava room. Looks pretty sweet. Huh, there's actually an invisible wall in this staircase. Rather bemusingly. Huh, is that gonna apply for the whole thing? Huh. Yeah, he's applied a visible wall to a staircase. That's rather weird. Like the whole staircase is blocked off. Why did he not want the player to just jump over here? Why is there an invisible wall on this? That's just rather weird. Looks like we're gonna have to go in here and press this. I'll pop up the fresh red suit. Oh, we can actually escape the pit. So that makes us even more pointless. I feel like maybe we have to stay in the pit for a few minutes as well. Echidemons coming out of narrow cylindrical areas. Oh, followed by everything else showing up. Oh god. And then this turned into a slaughter map. Oh. Good grief, this turned into a slaughter map. Wait. Out of complete nowhere. Well, well, I don't know, this is kind of slaughter map-ish. Like, yeah, this is definitely some kind of slaughtery encounter. Just begs the question of why he didn't want the staircase. I'm starting to understand why he didn't want the player to use the staircase, but it's kind of a lame way of doing it, you know, just having the invisible wall like that. I guess he didn't want the player to go up the staircase and then jump back around. I mean, it cuts off a loop, but it's kind of a lame way of doing it. I mean, putting an invisible wall without any kind of reason behind it, it just looks visually weird, you know. Oh, Doomguy is too scared to jump off this staircase. A mid-texture might be useful there, or something. Vents, maybe? Yeah, it's a pretty decent reveal. I was about to say this reminds me a bit of Quinarsho's Kakademon area, but this is actually more exciting. I've said it's actually really not, because we still have the same end product. We have Kakademons en masse, but at least there were more enemies around. This Kakko Swarm is still alive. Hmm. Not a very hard slaughtery encounter. Heard this music before. Yeah, this music does sound like it's been some kind of old game type music. Perhaps Bemuse will enter the chat at some point and explain what this map is. Killing this Kakko Swarm. Could use plasma, but I'm going to save that for the next bit. Oh shit, be careful. Nice. It's a nice room with this lava effect. And I like the way the Kakos came out of the fights. You see, Quinarsho, this is how you make Kakademons coming out of pipes more interesting. You have other enemies in the room. You don't just have an entire run passageway of Kakademons coming out of tubes for no reason. I hope he learns from that in his final version of the tech powers that he has in mind. Those who remember Quinarsho's brutal doom experimentation map. Alright, not too difficult. I was expecting that to be a touch harder. Eh, you made it. Fucking dope. Well, I'm glad I came back and dealt with those, that jerk. Not anymore. I don't know, if you pay attention to that, it's kind of easy to counter that archvile positioning, really. Try his very fluky shot. Oh, actually almost connected. Where'd he go? Oh, did I knock him off? I did. That was a court punish there. Oof, almost. Get out of here. Best of all your sky transfers then, and mutts. Oh my god, these fucking art revenants. Ugh. They're really placed in an awkward spot. I don't have to chain them right at that one at a time. Not cool. I sweep them, maybe. Get down. Can we please stop putting revenants? This is a really annoying revenant position. I don't like it at all. Ugh. Die? Why am I off my... thank you. Plus we need a lot of chain gun ammo for this. Okay, we're almost free of the Revenant Incursion. Where's the... Oh, there's one, only one left now. Hey, there we go. Bye, Revs. No, you don't. There might be a little ambush when this is triggered. Maybe killing this, secret hider with legs might help. That could be useful. Alright, let's see what happens when we enter here and press buttons. Oh, lift. I assume that's going to open up some kind of access point. Oh, here we go. that to do. It feels a bit weird having the different crate textures out here, actually, like this. That's not quite right, having the crate textures like this. It looks, I mean, it's fine with they're all jumbled in a pattern, but having them just like four across the wall like that, it looks a bit, well, gallery-esque, shall we say. Like you're doing it for a gallery or something. Oh, back. No, there doesn't appear to be anything else to this area other than getting. Was there anything else I could have done? Oh, there must be something back. There must be something we have to do further back then. I would assume. Wow, I actually have to go into the pain center to build these steps. Wow, that was the third backtrack of the level. Whoa, he gave us a Mega Spear and all the rockets we could ever ask. Oh, Jesus. Are you gonna, like, just... No, okay, don't resurrect, just charge in like a maniac. Solid strategy of the Archvile. Resurrect these enemies? Nah, I'm just gonna charge in. That was like the third backtrack of the level. Amazingly. You must have something big, Quang, because you just gave us a bazillion and one rockets. Missing cage thing. Oh Jesus, he has an Eratatron. And it's a second wow, that looks so weird. Ah shit. Fucking I got the wrong weapon here. The wrong weapon and the wrong corner. Oh dear. I think we may have to try and kill this Eratatron thing very quickly. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to go for the plasma here. We're gonna kill off all these specters. Boom. Interesting how he manages to make this crate yard quite open. Ish, sort of. I really don't have any. Oh, and now I have a chance to use some rockets finally, but oh god, this is a really nasty cactus. Try rockets again, now I got a bit of distance. Here he is encouraging rocket usage here. It's kind of scary to do that because they just scatter all over the place then, but I don't have much of a choice. I have to... Oh god, they're going everywhere. I have to manage these scattered cacodemons going all over the place. Oh shit. This is not the most easy to circle strafing ground either. Oh, what? Oh, you can escape the pit. Wow, that was a relief. I thought I was screwed then, but it was like inescapable pit time. This cactus swarm's gonna take a while to kill. Go with the cactus just yet. I don't really want them wandering around either. I'll fire a few and then try and pick off a few of the SMGs as they come in through the range and whatnot. Managed to get away with a much more interesting caco swarm here. I mean, the arena here is pretty good. It's like the tactic here is your standard circle strafing, but it's, you gotta be careful due to the props usage. This is actually this is something that Steve D would be proud of. You know, an effective caco swarm due to the area. Because a caco swarm that's not got an area around it, it's kind of boring to deal with. A large flying lump. When used effectively, it's an entertaining large flying lump to deal with. I'm gonna assume there's a... Wow. That Arachnotron did not fire once during that whole fight. The other one did. Strange. I wonder why the other one didn't bother to fire. Oh, Jesus. I'm glad I didn't go any further into this crate maze, because there was extra balance in it. Yeah, and all those setters are different types to raise to the correct one. Oh god, I find basic mapping... Oh, there was extra plasma back here I could have used. Man, it wasn't really much of a chance to explore once the crate dropped. Inspired by violence and ancient aliens. Looking forward to playing ancient aliens to see how it stacks up against Valiant and... What on earth did I just lower? Something. Oh! What the fuck was that? Saw a hall of mirrors there. Big ass hall of mirrors effect there. Oh shit, how did the Archbell get behind me? And where the hell did they go? Okay, I don't know what happened here. Something weird. Oh, I see. He teleports them into the level. Oh, dude, that is so evilly dickish. I just spent the entire fucking thing and you're resurrecting the entire archfight. No, I don't like this. This is a little bit too far dickish for my liking. How am I gonna kill all of them? And we got a hole of mirrors too on the walls. Oh, maybe that BFG will be useful. We can actually get to the damn thing. No! Don't raise it back up. For God's sake. Put all that shit down and keep it down. Hey, Faircore. Come on. Thank you. Oh, crap. We actually do have to... Got all the mirrors here. Did This is bad. Oh god. Wow, this is really fucking lame. I basically have to get lucky to get into the BFG early. Looks like the Dark Trials are supposed to teleport, though. But they don't. No, 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 no. This is not a cool thing to do. They should have, either that or they should all be teleporting. All of them. But they don't often just flink, stay around. I mean, I think this gives me a chance to kill one or two of them off, but... Aww, why does it go back up? Why? Bemused, the lift should... This should just be a one-time lift that stays down. This encounter is already quite dickish enough as it is. We don't need any extra... Please teleport away so I can... I think that was a sound effect. How did that get me? How the fuck did that get me? I was behind a goddamn wall. And I was hit somehow. Nah, I don't think we can win this fight. I think it's time to retreat. Immediately away. Alright, it's time to get out of here. How do we get out? How do we get out of this? There's a Baron. No, I don't like this encounter, so... I don't like it at all. This should stay down. This should not go back up. That basically means the player has to then wait extra time. And honestly, the player can't afford extra time when they're dealing with fucking archvows. I'm not happy with that. It's really poorly thought executed. I mean, yeah, I think they should stay, the idea should stay the same. The archvow should teleport and, like, try and resurrect shit, but I don't think you should have blocked the player additionally just to get this weapon out, because by the time they are resurrecting the countless cacos, then they're gonna know what to do anyway. What actually am I supposed to go with this? Really kind of... Yeah, it is awesome to see veteran mappers help out new. How are you supposed to complete this though? Does the thing go back the same way? No, I'm not really amused, because unless there's a purpose for this being used a second time, I don't know why it doesn't... First of all, there's a glowing hole with mirrors that needs to be fixed, obviously. And second of all, this... Unless this lift has a secondary purpose, which I guess we're going to have a look at now. Maybe it leads to a room? Ah, it leads to the exit. Okay. Oh, it was a God Spear. Oh, so if I can actually get onto the elevator and have the Archvows teleport, I could God Spear down, get the red... So actually, this could be entirely semi-skipped-ish. I think? Oh wait, no, the red key probably opens access to this thing or whatever. I'm gonna punch the air and try and trigger the Archvows early. Please. Are they not supposed to all teleport away? I don't know. I'm gonna check. I'm gonna go up and see if it does have a locked door to it or not. I guess that gives this lift a bit. Oh, yeah, it does. Alright. Alright, whatever. We'll kill the Archvows and come back. Godspear is kind of pointless then, because it's right at the end of the level. Really lame. Won't be amused at all, no. I'm just gonna fucking go for the ending. This is a fight that will go on forever if you let it. So I'm just gonna skip to the end and wait for the lift to come down and then leave the level. Can you please come down? Okay, okay, go, 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 go. Fucking hell, lift, can you please go up? Thank you. Oof, finally. I guess that's it. I guess that's how this encounter works. Oh, in case you want to go out there and get UV max, there's a God Spear. No, I really don't like that. That is kind of awkward, honestly. I mean, I think I just did it in the way that was intended, but... that's so awkward, though. You know, you force the player... A, the archviles don't all instantly teleport out the way. B, the lift goes back up. I mean, it takes a fair amount of time, but I don't like that. That was kind of iffy for the final encounter of the map. I think, if anything, what should have happened is the player should have... the archviles should have teleported at the beginning, before the player saw the BFG. And then they come in behind and start resurrecting cacos everywhere. And then the player has to rush to the red switch. And then the player has to wait for the lift. I don't think they should have been on the lift, guarding the key and the BFG in the first place. I think they should have come in from somewhere else or something. I could see the idea he had there, but that was really awkward. That's home. You don't think you'd finish playing Nova 1? Dude, you need to finish playing Nova 1, it's great. The only map that sucked on that was Joe Ilya's castle map. And his other one. But that was it. Nova 1 was great otherwise. I guess there was also the disappointing title map as well, where there's a big area and nothing was in it, but... And again, Nova received a few fixes since then, so maybe they've patched out some of the issues. That was like two or three years ago now? So, yeah, generally this map was... I liked how the backtracking wasn't too bad. He seemed to have some... He likes to use a lot of monsters in his encounters. He's definitely not going to be a mapper of small-scale encounters. Judging by the fact the next map's a slaughter map is more than evidence of that. So... You know, I like the Kako Swarm with the crates. It was quite difficult because of the environment. You know, I had to circle strafe around a crate area is not easy with a large red blob. And you could see a few texture errors. That home was a bit bad. Generally, though, it was pretty decent map in all, I would say. Pretty decent. I'm gonna let you all put your... What do you all think of that? I'm gonna get myself a drink real quick, and I'll be right back, and then we'll play his second map, which is a slaughter map. So, brace yourselves for lots of carnage. Back in a moment. Alright, I am back. Alright, so... 3,176 monsters. This mini. Yeah. So we're in for a lot of enemies in this. As you can already guess. Oh my god. Oh, this is a Slayer mini. Yeah, this is War Assembler by Slayer. Damn, that's more monsters than in my sword map. But Mew said this was apparently easy. I don't believe him. Well, I've actually had a little peek at this. To open the map, you have to actually punch the door. Let the carnage begin. Oh Oh god, the Hall of Mirrors is strong in this one. Archfowls are the real nasty things here. I can't even attack them though because of the Gagga Swarm. I'm gonna have to wait a while. Fucking Archfowls. They must die. Oh, I don't even have Berserk. There's no point in using the fist at all. We need those archfowls. Oh great. And the archfowl positioning here is really dickish. As you'd probably expect from the sword map. So many enemies here. I need to get rid of these fucking archfowls, but the fucking cacodemons are blocking them. If I gave them one shot, I'd be looking. I mean, the Cacodemon is also kind of... Oh, if I can kill the Archfowls, I should win. Easier said than done, though. Especially with the Cacodemon still around, too. God. Dear God. Oh, yeah, this is easy bemused. I want to question that right off the bat. Wait here for the Archfowl to disappear. I've not really played Sunder, so I can't really comment on that. I'll just have to take your word for it. A little better this time so far. Trying to avoid picking up all the armor. Alright, I'm not doing too bad with this time. You can sort of circle strafe a bit, but every now and then, because of the fucking archfowl, stop walking onto me. Holy crap. I removed the archfowls, I can circle strafe forever, but the archfowls exclusively make this. Encounter what it is. Just kill one of them right off the bat, that'd be great. I just did. Good, one less to deal with. That's not like I have to actually take cover. So this is kind of a I have to get lucky enough not to get Archfowl to death. Oh, okay. Again, if I kill the Archfowls then I win. That's all I have to do. I get rid of them and I prevail. The rest of this is just circle strafing. I mean, I can't stay still because the Cacko Swarm will eat me alive if I do. So. Maybe if I'm lucky, the Archfowls will kill themselves or something. I might try and make a save in a minute. Ah, stop looking on to me. Might try and make a save in a minute if I can. Yeah, I'm fine with it. It looks like a few of the archviles have already bit the dust here. Great news for me. Not enough though. Okay. I really, really want to save, but there's no real good place to do it. I hit him at least. I can just hit an archvile every time I pass one. But again, I... Fuck's sake! Wow, Bemuse, you're an ass. This is not easy at all, Bemuse, because you don't give me a BFG. Yeah, with this is infinitely tall actors, this map would be imbalanced. The bottom line is this encounter is only hard because of the archvile placement, which I suppose he deliberately did. But you can't call this easy. This is not fucking easy. Fucking ridiculous. I can't stay still to pop the arch valves. I can't even move. I'm not even going to continue attempt that run. I don't like this at all.
Yeah.
This is not easy, Bemused. Can I actually, like, close the door on this? Oh, no, I can't, because then they just come in. Nah, this won't work. Damn. Can't afford of everything here. So, I can't even stay still. I can't sit still for a minute, because if I stay still, I get swarmed and revenant rocketed. But the rest of this really is just circle strafing. I just need to eliminate all the arch valves and I win. Oh, it's going well. Hidden, then the bomb is, I don't know where it might be. Oh, there we go. Start off, Marshmallow. No, seriously, start off. Oh, that made things much, much, much. No, Fadco, that just made things 80 bazillion fucking times worse. Yeah, all that did was unleash the other three doors, which resulted in revenants. The last thing I need is more enemies to cluster my space up. Alright. Well, I can't even grab the BFG because... Well, the only thing I could do here is just keep running and running and running until the archviles are eliminated. Once the archviles are dead, I can pick up the BFG and go to phase 2. Fucking hell. Hey, Steve D. Not seen you in a little bit. How's it going? Can't say I'm a big fan of this map. Let's have the players sit still at Archbower turn.
No!
That's it. I'm done. No. No. Fuck that map. I'm not playing it. It's fucking... That map is designed for sword mappers. You can have it. Fuck that shit. Jesus Christ. I don't even know if I want to continue that map. That looks... God, fuck's sake. How the hell am I supposed to beat that? Well, I guess the only way to beat it is to just... It's a really boring circle around and wait till the Archbowers are killable. Kill them all, and then... God, it's gonna be so boring. Alright, let's try again. Yeah, that is... Oh, you come out... Oh, you've already come out of the chat to say that I'm Mad War Snail too. What kind of fan are you? Why don't you say hello? Oh, wow. If you actually fist the... Oh, if you actually fist before the start, you trigger him early. I don't want that. I block my entrance. Bastard. In a few seconds, I'm coming back at it. Hey, Evan UI, how's it going? Good to see you. Well, we know the strategy for this. We just have to get lucky enough to pull it off. Well, that's death. Yep, time to quick save abuse. Alright, so all we have to do is just kill the Archbowers. In about 5 minutes from now, once everything else is dead. Easier said than done. It's not that easy to circle around all of this. If I stop for 1 second, I'm practically a GG. Fuck's sake, stop fucking walking onto me. I'm going to do some cuntbags. Holy crap, MTX, there's a God Spear here. This changes everything. You... go fuck yourself. The other way, all of you. It doesn't last long enough. Needs to last. That's a good run, though. Oh. I'm saving here. Wow, very nice catch there. How did we kill with that? Like, three? That's better than... Oh my god.
No, amused, I do not
like this encounter. I don't like this. I really, really don't fucking like this. This is the exact same problem that the... Sword maps are not about players having to dodge RNG shots. It's about combat puzzles, but combat puzzles with a... Ugh! God! AOE 0256. Oh, no! This is not what a Swarter map is supposed to be like. Swarter maps are supposed to give you... the fact that this whole map is just circle around the map and wait for the fucking 5 minutes for enemies to kill each other. I prefer Swarter maps where you can actually do something. You know, it's not Archvile based. It's fucking... I fucking hate this. Hate this shit. See the idea. Yeah, congratulations, you made 8 dickish archvows. Unfortunately, you also made the map from RNG-tastic because of it. Ugh. God fucking damn it. Not an idea of a fun map. It's so nice if the Archvile would place a little difference to be able to die as well. Love it. So many is left then? I got more than fucking 2, I got 3 at least. Yeah, so it's like an entire quadrant where I can't stay still in this quadrant. I got 3 Archviles out of 8. There's 5 to go. I have to wait still. I have to hold on to poke into the cacos. Miles away. Oh, hang on, now I fell. Oh no. Dying. Don't know if I want that particularly. It means less things to kill everything else. Ow. Just need to kill the archer. Maybe not the best place there, but it'll have to do. Wow, that wasn't worth it at all. That was not... Yeah, I get hit by a Hell Knight projectile, but it's not too bad. I only take 10% damage. I know, the Scythes are dying. I just have to kill every archer. The thing is, I can't stay around for 2 shots, and I can't do a quick strafe. I have to keep moving, because there's Revenants firing, Hell Knights firing, Cacos everywhere. So we have to just circle around over and over and over and over and over and over and over until they're dead. Then we can play the map how I want it. This is the problem. I mean... Yes, I have raised worse than this. Like, a lot worse. Go and watch Resurgence if you want to see the pinnacle of Suitepee. Okay, I think he dies now. At last. That was just to kill one fucking archvile, too. Now I need to kill another one. Mercifully, the fighting is starting to thin out just a little bit. I did not appreciate that archer attack me there. by about 50 reps. Okay, whatever. I can take an armor now. Save. Alright. And then Akako intercepts my archbow kill. Very good. Got him. We're getting there now. We're getting there. I'd really like to use my rockets, but it's way too risky. I can actually start to move around using the inner circle now. Yeah, I can use the inner circle now to move around. All the sides of it. Oh, but wait, I'm getting hit more now. Somewhat. Oh, I got him there. Yeah, the crossfire is becoming more of a threat here, though. From the stamps. Oh my god, so be careful. Ow, 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 ow. No, not dead. Holy tamale. Shouldn't be too bad if I can keep an eye on me. There's one left. Shit, don't give up the pattern. Just keep going. Get our shard. This giant cacao swarm is going to be useful, actually. Wave 2. Finally. The bloody archvow is dead. Now I'm just checking for any armor left. Oh, health spear does help. Any chance of an armor pickup? Round this off a bit. No. Okay. Let's get away from all of them and save. Ugh, finally. Now I can re- Wow. 2,000 monsters dead. So we've killed. Alright, let me just read the chat here. Hey, Four Shot Blast, how's it going? Alright. No, I haven't finished my Nova 3 map. Yes, the deadline as is today, but it's an Alpha 1 deadline. No, it's not a mandatory deadline. Otherwise, I would have to relinquish from the project, obviously. And yes, I do plan on playing Sunwast this summer at some point. I'm going to play a whole bunch of Slaughter maps before then. To practice. So this will be good practice, I guess. For it. Now, at this point, we could consider going in for the BFG and seeing what comes out. It seems to be Revenant-based, so... But we actually made it. So it's this map is not impossible, it's just that the method of doing it is kind of lame. I don't like it. I mean, you know when people say like you circle strafe around an arena to sort of figure out what's going on to force an infight? I can't even go inside without getting attacked. Alright, now let's see what pours out of these gates or whatever. Well, here's the first problem, it's Revenants, so that already sucks. Oh, fucking Revenants. Well, this second part might suck. Hey, Seawolf, how's it going? I don't know whether I should eliminate everything now, or whether I should... Nah, I think I need the monsters here to infight. I just need to pick a better infight area. Oh, it's also busy, though. I'd imagine you have to go in there without everything swarming down on me instantly like this. Ridiculous. Yeah, some monsters will also be more well-designed, in general. But this is awkward. I have to already be ready to fire the BFG because of the stupid cackle swarm, and then the revs everywhere? What the hell am I going to do with revenants? Oh, I have to fire this as soon as I get it. I have to break the cackle swarm out. Okay, this is where the bullshit starts. How the hell am I supposed to survive the revenant swarms? I have no cover. And they just flood every quadrant. Unless I am missing something. It doesn't seem like the second part of this map is doable. About a god sphere or something. Now I don't know whether I should kill everything in this room or not before engaging this mega spear. Maybe so I don't get cackle swarmed on immediate entry. I mean, I do lose infighting potential, but will that be needed at all? I'm not sure what to do here. I'm either going to clear this room completely and then open the gates of the revenants, or I'm going to leave it as is and they can be used as infighting distractions. I have to do whatever's needed. Can I? I'm sad I can't stay. Alright, so what happens? One of the cages opens up. About 80,000 revs come out of the corner. Switch needs to be pulled. And then revs. Excuse me, but you don't have 80,000 revs right now unless the player has somewhere to actually deal with. I wonder if this HOM is a deliberate effect or not. By Bemused, or whether we just literally forgot all these textures. You know, I have half a feeling this is actually a deliberate thing by him. I think he did these deliberately. These homes. I don't think they're an accident. There's no way of getting. You have to get lucky as hell, really. I mean, every quadrant opens up with fucking revenants? What am I supposed to do about this exactly? I'm really struggling to see what I'm supposed to actually do here. That opens up, that opens up. I guess all of them are supposed to open up, except this one, which is the one I came out of. I mean, what's the player supposed to do here? Am I just gonna have to get lucky? Again? Well, what doesn't help is, I'm actually thinking to eliminate the cackle swarm a bit more before we actually go into the... That way I can actually take the BFG in peace without being immediately swarmed there. So I'm gonna thin out this cackle swarm a lot. Because they're just going to get in the way of everything. And they're not going to really do a whole bunch for me. So I'm going to thin out this Kako swarm a bit so we can actually... what's it about the damage? I don't die. Because I will be getting a Mega Sphere. Yeah, you'll whoop this one, Steve D. This guy likes to use Kako swarms quite somewhat effectively as well. So many of them, it's ridiculous. I wonder if I should actually be using the outer circle here a little bit. Oh, this is gonna take a while. I have to mow down the Kako swarm a bit because I need to get the BFG peacefully when I do eventually take it, so. This is gonna take a while. Not too bad about the damage, but I'm gonna save just to save time for everyone. I have no armor left. Come on now, swarm. So I almost plan to kill these guys, but maybe not. I might need them a little bit. In truth, I might need the Kako swarm too, but not this big. Not while I'm desperately trying to actually get the BFG when I want. Just need enough of it so I can get a little gap when I go and get the BFG. All I need. I don't need to have every single one killed. Just enough so that when I move into the middle, there's a gap that I can then exploit. I wasn't a fan of the Cyber Demon in the first map. Yeah, the Cyber Demon was kind of just meh, nothing particularly great. Nice build-up for it, but after when it arrived, it wasn't really a big deal or anything. I'm wasting all the rockets, I'm gonna use rockets once we get to the actual fight. Come on now. We're getting there. Okay, I think that's enough of the gap. That's enough of the gap. Now we can focus on killing the devs. Get them all out. I'm not sure what to do. It's the part where I need to figure out what to do about the revenants. But this is why revenants are bullshit, because you know, you can't dodge homing attacks. Oh, wait, the rest of them. I really don't know what happens now. I can't hide from the revenants. I might have to just try and kill off a whole bunch, but I can't stay still. Because of the thing. Yeah, I think this is the part where the map completely shits itself. What the fuck is a player supposed to do against this kind of thing? How is a player supposed to take any cover from Rev Swarm from 3/4 of the map? At this point, a God Spear should have been thrown in somewhere. Now, I suppose there's an argument that I could have done this at the beginning of the map. But... holy crap. Now, I want to see Bemused fix this. I don't think you could just go in on the map straight away, immediately. I mean, if you do it straight away, you have even less room to move. So I don't think you could do this at the start of the map, surely. like, as you go straight in and have them appear, because then you have even less space to... What is a Dobu? Oh, that's Dobu Gabumaru, the... Hey, Obake, how's it going? Topsy-turvy day. You can talk about it if you want, sure. Why don't you fire rockets at the ranks while you are circling? I don't want to because I want to keep them alive for infighting purposes, Fadcore. It doesn't make any difference. The more distractions the Revenants have, the better for me, but I don't know if that's even a problem or even going to help. Because the problem is just the sheer number of them. It comes back to the point, do I clear this room completely and then unleash the switch so I have nothing to snipe me off, or do I pull it now and use them as a distraction, a few occasional distractions? I don't think these are serving any purpose, but they're not going to be really dangerous either, because the main threat is just the best form itself. Yeah, infighting. Although I don't think they're even going to do that very well. I'm not quite sure what to do. There's only one room that doesn't open up of the three, but... So this is either mass fighting immediately, or... I don't know. The thing is, though, when they teleport from the film, I mean, you get one... Two... Three... Massive breath storm, which is impossible to survive. I guess the only thing to do is just to brute force an exit at this point. I don't think I can actually beat this. Start over. That was the wrong side. Yeah, I'm supposed to go into this one. Yeah. Fuck off. Oh, forget this. I'm gonna do this my way. How about some silence? Let's go figure out how to beat this map quickly. Right. Switch. I'm gonna assume that's the X. Okay. I assume this is the second switch. And I'm going to then assume that the exit is now open. Yes. Then there's a third. But then it's not over yet. Ah, then the middle becomes available. Oh, there's more arch rails in the middle. Great. And then there's the exit, right? Okay, right. So I know how the rest of the level goes now. So there's going to be 8 extra arch valves as well to deal with. But the exit's there for the taking once that happens. So really, this is kind of a race to the finish. Not sure what to do now. Yeah, I'm just going to have to get to both switches, kill as many as possible on the way in. The thing is, I have no armor back. I have no super power-ups left. It makes you wonder if I'm supposed to do this early, like... I would say you do this at the beginning. Like, you take the God Spear, you... Let me try something. Maybe we use that God Spear at the beginning, not to kill off Archvals, but to get the map done faster. So... Anyway. Get off me, for fuck's sake. Go. Thank you.
wrong door.
The only problem with this strategy is then once the God Spear wears off, you're immediately in trouble. Now that does get you some progress, but you still gotta press two switches and then break it to the third one, trigger it and then run to the exit. Yeah, this map sucks. I think I can't say I like this very much. There was death though. I don't know what to do here. This fucking cacto swarm does not help either. No, this isn't nearing the end at all. Au contraire. If I can, I broke out then. But then what do you do? You're gonna break out a second time. Make it to the Mega Spear. Wow. Yeah, this map sucks. Sorry, Bemused. This is awful. Way of doing this unless you get really lucky, like you have to run from Mega Spear to Mega Spear just to do it. I'm not taking that one. So that one is the lift exit. So I need to take one near a switch. Or, you know, without getting hit by every Kaka Demon in the room. The only way of doing this is to run from Mega Spear to Mega Spear, literally. Take as little damage as possible on the way. So it's like, grab Mega Spear, next room go. It's RNG. Bullshit. If I do it before the swarm appears. I just die horribly. Only decided he was... I suppose if they come out a little bit, there's a kind of a half chance to get around them temporarily. But then they come back in and form the big passive flank, so then we'll... I'm going to the next one. This is a risky save I'm pulling right now. Then I have to go through the third pack of them. Might have a chance now. Just gotta find the correct switch here. Just leg it in. Don't even wait. Just go, 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 go. Wow, bullshit. That's just to get back through to the edge and then go for the other side again. Just to hit the third switch so I can then go... Ba-doom. Then I need to wait the arch valves up. And then bullshit. The arch valve swarm gets me. Hang on, where do these cybers come from suddenly? There's cybers on the map again. Interesting. There are now cybers on the map again. Hmm. Maybe I should try a different idea here. Move out the way. Move. God's sake. Yeah, but this is Sunder the I don't know what balances edition. I think Sunder will be more forgiving than this. This is a pile of shit. The Muse has got to, if he wants to be a Swarder Master, I think he's got to go back to the drawing board. Yeah, there's a third switch. I'm actually on 90% health here. I would actually consider saving. No, let's get again. Right, I just now I need the Archvile to disappear. We're not going for a kill all. We're just gonna leg it straight into the exit. Oh, come the fuck on. Can you please be busy fighting something else? Like wow food. I would dispute that. Now I have to wait for the fucking Archvile to fuck off. Long enough I can have a clear run. Oh, don't tell me monster plotlines. Do not tell me he's put monster plotlines in. Done. Awful. I'm gonna set up a donation for Soundproof Foam. I have no idea how much that costs. Alright. That's it. That's... Seriously. If there's one thing I'd like to donate, is a fucking soundproof foam. Adrial sounds being interrupted. I might as well just do fucking no my extreme. What a fucking god. I'm so fed up. Alright, well, anyway. Master block? No, monster block lines, Fadcore. It's a line where the monsters can't go over them. The monster block lines are where a monster can't go past a certain point. The idea is to keep them in a certain area if you don't want them to roam around too much. I don't know if the Archvowels were monster block lines, but I suspect they were. Oh, that was just too many monsters, they couldn't actually get out to do what they were going to do. This is a different offer to Bemused. I'm not impressed with that Swarder map at all. The entire Swarder map came down to luck. I could see the kind of puzzle that he wanted to create with that, but I'm not impressed at all. The fact that you gotta kill Archvowels and wait 5-10 minutes to do that. The fact that you have rev spam, nothing but rev spam for the entire thing, and then it was just, oh god, that was awful. The whole of mirror effect did nothing for me. I just ignored it very quickly. So whether that's intentional or not, I don't know, but I did not enjoy that map at all. Are you finished up? Are you playing anything else? I was doing laundry and doing more Nova 3 compiling. I don't know. There is one more thing I could test, but I'm also tempted to wrap this up early. And I could do something else. Maybe play some Overwatch or read a book or whatever. I don't know what to do. But what do you all think of that? Bemused. What did you all think of that? Hey, Naomi, though, by the way. Sorry, it took a while. There is actually one other thing I could test. I think. Might do that. If I could go extra bonus, and then I can PM him afterwards. I don't know. I think Bemused One seems to know. I mean, he did a good Kako Swarm on the first map with the second encounter, particularly with the crates. So he's clearly trying to make some interesting slaughtery encounters, and he seems to sometimes have a knack for that. But I think this is a sign of a mapper who's still learning how to do that kind of encounter. Yeah, the first map wasn't too bad. I mean, it had texture alignment problems. And okay, the arch vows at the end was stupid, but it wasn't bad. And I like the idea of using that psycho swarm the way he did, the second one anyway. Weird, but some weird things, like the staircase with invisible walls, but I had no reason to be there. Really, it was just stupid. This is clearly a mapper that is, you could, as I said, this is a first time mapper, so he's obviously focusing on trying to funnel players in a very specific way. He seems to know how to get players to do certain encounters his way. You know, close his doors, have things, etc. You're not going to try and really cheap him out. But I think he needs to work more on making the actual encounters a bit less sucky. I mean, the second map was a clusterfuck of unenjoyable fun. Sorry, a clusterfuck of non-enjoyment, I should say. I mean, sorta maps are fun once you figure out how to beat them. And there's usually a few ways of doing it, or there's one way of doing it. But that one, it's like when you know, unless I've missed something, and I probably have, maybe someone like Nivanos could run through that and maybe see how he thinks, someone who's a bit more experienced with sorta map encountery type things. But it didn't feel fun when the solution for me was handle the RNG arch vows, handle the RNG rev swarms to chase the mega spears, and then handle the RNG arch vow BFG clusterfuck to beat the ending. I mean, Bemused himself said this was quite easy-ish if you let the revs come out early. So maybe there's a method where if you unleash everything, it starts off easy. But I don't know. I can't see that being easier because the revs have come out. You see anything? It seems like you have less space to work with. Hide from anything. But I didn't like the second map. You know, sort of maps have to be, they have to be fine-tuned where, I mean, I'll get frustrated at sorta maps usually, but I can usually see when I figure out the solution. It's very satisfying to clear an enemy counter out, but that one wasn't very satisfying. It was just, ugh. Detailing was mice. Squeak, squeak. You saw one sorta map that really impressed you a few months ago, but I don't remember the name. It was on a mountain. Lots and lots of cacos. I can't play stuff like this on my PC, I don't think. Oh no, Twitch ate the message again. That sucks. I can't say that was unplayable, but I think Bemused has got to do a lot of learning about sorta map encounters. I can see that he's trying to do some interesting stuff, but he's gonna have to work on it. That's my take on it. The first map was decent, and the second map was awful. You know, whether the Hall of Mirror effect was intentional or was part of some kind of bizarre effect, I think it could have been replaced. So I wish Bemused was in the chat right now to discuss that, but here we go. I think the mapper has some potential as a slaughter mapper, but he's going to have to learn to make the encounters work. I mean, when, like, you know, you have to do hard in the right way. I've said this before. You have to do hard in the right way. You want it to be challenging, but you don't want it to be ridiculously unfair and unfun to deal with the challenge. It's hard to get that balance right, I feel. But, yeah. So, there's that. And I'm going to put that on the rest list. Actually, there is one more map I could actually try. I think there's one more map I might do actually real quick. Let me just see if I can. Messages here. Here we go. Player wasn't done working on currently. Are you working on it? Oh, he has a thread for it as well. Okay, cool. I'll have to put it into the thread then. Alright then. Well, as a little bonus, we'll play another one that I was sent, and then I'll be done. So, right here. Lock. L-U-K. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. Second ZQT zap. No. Not ZDT zap. No. Not at all. Sweet. Would you mind showing off my newest castle? Alright then, Steve D. I look forward to Realms of Unholy Chaos whenever you're going to do that. Thanks for coming by, Steve D. MTX, I was able to get a Steam key for the full version of Raptor Call of the Shadows thanks to a friend of mine. I could send you a free copy if you'd like. Newest castle. Maybe another time, Evan UI. To be honest with you, I would like to play your map when it's finished. When it comes to like stuff in progress, I tend to like playing stuff when it like maybe once or twice in development and then play the finished version, which is why I no longer playtest any of Obake's stuff, because I just want to see his finished product after all the monster testing I've done for him. And with the same with... Oh, bugger, that wasn't supposed to show up on the stream. Yeah, private messages show up on the stream. If, for some reason. Well, that'd be much appreciated. I mean, if you want to send me a free copy, you're more than welcome to do so. However, it may be a while before I get around to it, because I'm not playing any of my other game requests until Fallout 4 is finished, so... Maybe you should hold on to that copy. And that's not forgetting... Yeah, I would hold on to that. I may have to trim my lists even more. Maybe. I don't know. Alright, so... I'll happily play the finished version of your Castlevania thing, Evan UI, when it is finished. I've seen enough, but I don't want to see any... Especially since I've seen all the... Kind of seen all the maps, I kind of want to see a finished version before I play anymore. Yeah, okay. Anyway, I'm detracting from LUK Nissa's moment of playtesting. So, this is Canyon.wad, and I believe this uses a lot of GZ Doom type features, because this is why I had to update GZ Doom recently, was because of this map on the earlier version. So, let's play. So, as you can see here, we have the fans. Get good. I'm working on that. So I think this is one of what they call the poly objects or something when you use for fans and cool stuff. So this is something he's working on as well. He has a thread for it. So yeah, here we are. Looks like we're going to see a lot of GD Doom type features. Okay. Anything in the toilet? Nope. Just health kits if I need them. And yes. Ooh, we have music. What the hell? What happened there? Huh. I could have sworn he disappeared behind that waterfall, but how's that possible exactly? I didn't just see that, did I? It looked like he disappeared into the waterfall, but how's that possible? Okay, yeah, there's some weird effect here. Freeze fire again from the distance. It's only one range shot, so it won't hit me, but... Something weird. How the hell has he done that? Wait till the stream is finished before you send your sexy self to sleep. Yeah, for some reason it goes through the waterfall. How did he manage to pull that off? That must be some kind of weird glitch. Like, I might not have noticed that, but the guy standing in front of it? There's like a weird behind the thing. What the heck? I have never seen that kind of effect before. Very strange. But yeah, this was actually sent to me via a private message on Doom won't, so... Yay, shells. All the good shit. What is this new? No armor bonuses that are stacked up to the gills. Clearly. Well, cheers for popping on by, old Bucky. Where is it? Sounds like a news bulletin's about to start. This is John Suitepee News, live from the canyon. This looks good despite requiring cheesy doom. Quite sad. We're not going to start all that malarkey again of the Zaydoom snobbery. Oh, it's Zaydoom, it's bad. Told you, we need more people to do these kind of maps. And do them well. I mean, when a Zaydoom map works really well, it looks really good. And we had that fan again. I don't even know if these are called poly objects because of Mega Blast 98 stream. He went throughout to do one for his map to the Mega Blast 98 community project. So that's why I know they're called poly objects. Some kind of. It's a Zaydoom specific thing. Ooh, secret. But not a secret, apparently. So it's like we have a base revolving around a canyon of slime, anyway. Seems to be the deal here. Oh! We even have some slopes. I don't think I want to go any further over there. I was semi-curious to check it out, but... It's using advanced features of, I feel, like those fans, for instance. It's a Zaydoom Stein map, I think, so. No joke, this is a Zaydoom style thing that he's working on. Ah, shit, I can't even hit those. Luckily for me, they're only pistol zombies. Oh, he's meant to be like... Huh. Okay. I guess crouch is at least enabled. I'll get through those otherwise. We have a ventilation system. Beautiful. Oh! Wow, that's kind of cool. I like that. An exploding cacodemon afterwards. That was kind of cool. I like that. That was pretty sweet. Yeah, you need the latest version of Cheesy Doom to play this. I had to update my version. Although, to be fair, I updated mine for a few months, so... No biggie on that. So that's why I've updated... This is the WOD that made me update my... Cheesy Doom. The endless... Ow! Oh. You got crushed then. Damn, they need help. Bye bye, the bad guy. Oh shit. Oh, damn. Maybe some help can be found here? Was a horrible earlier. Fucking hell. Mm. Well, I need health. Badly. That bathroom would just wait yours. Got him. I'm not going that way again. Not immediately, anyway. I just thought I was an enemy for a second. Oh. What am I getting something? Shit, I need that chain gun from the previous area. I'll actually go up there and get it. What about music this is? Version from 1987. Damn it, I just want the chain gun. That's it. Finally. Yeah, I always use ZZ Doom. Oh, that's not a rat there. I thought because of that weird little barrier it was going to clam up and reveal fresh monsters for me to have to fight. Whatever this is. Using some fancy shit. One way or the other. I like these vents. It makes this feel a bit like a Duke Nukem type thing. They also appear to have some lighting. They also have some colored lighting effects. That looks good. Stay there for a sec. Get out of here. See ya. Oh god. I think jumping may also be an option here. Trying to think. I think we may have to enable jumping. I'm gonna put jumping on as well. And it's like, no! Oh, you can actually make it onto this. Can you climb this? Yes. Yeah, this is jumping enabled. There's too many cacodemons, though, so this is a really bad idea, and we're not gonna go this way anymore. In fact, we need to get out of this place immediately. Because fuck fighting all these cacodemons with not enough ammo on a platforming ledge. Oh, don't tell me I can't go back. Must be something I can do, surely. Fucking hell, are you seriously kidding me? I have to go down here and... Oh, hang on, is that... No, I can't do that even, because I've jumped into a vent. Damn it! I'm going to have to not botch this jump, then. The red suit would have been nice. Oh, the death zone. Ugh, I fucking hate jumping and platforming and fiddly little wedges like this. I mean, this is the way it's supposed to go. Am I stuck here now with no ammo? Does that mean I have to restart the whole level? One decision to go this way? I tried to wonder if mousework is going to need to be enabled for this. I can't even tell where to jump. Should we kill this cactus? Oh, hang on. It looks like there's a slope. I can't tell. I'm putting mousework on. I can't tell what I'm aiming for now. I don't know if this is supposed to be enabled, but I can't see what I'm aiming for, so... It looks like it is just a straight go for that platform, but... Or maybe go up here, but then have to avoid 3 extra cacos. I get up this part. Oh god, I don't have no clip bound. Shit. That's not even a possible jump. Yeah, Jesus Christ, momentum switch. I don't even know where I'm going here. Oh. Well, mousework has definitely improved things a bit. Anyway, go away. I'm trying to... Yep. Oh, come on. Fucking pain elemental. I have barely enough ammo as it is, and you're chucking these shits at me? Give me a break. No, I think we fucked up here. I think this is going to have to require a map restart. I don't think we're supposed to be here at all. I can't even get back to where I want to be right now. I don't know if I want to kill all these. Supposed to get up there to go up the top of this to go, what, jump over there? And then here? And then... What? Also, I'm gonna... There. Okay, never mind, no clip binding, but... I'm starting to think I might have fucked myself over. That's bad. Why is it in an exploratory map am I screwed myself over because I went one way? I have to do this stupid jump. I can't actually make that jump at all. I have to come down here and... Oh, hang on. I know where to get to. I can't even get to that. There's no jumping platform high enough for that. No, this is... You can't just... Why am I being punished for going through a vent and then dropping down somewhere and not seeing an obvious way out? This seriously may require a map restart. Which means... I'm not happy. Wasting my time because I took the wrong fucking path. I mean, I already felt there was a bit of a health and ammo shortage after that first room, but now it's like... What's the... Go this way... Go away... Thank you... Then what? Jesus, do you think there's enough cacos here? Well, that's a map restart. Oh dear! That's a bad thing. Here's a hint, illuknisaa. If I go the wrong fucking way... I should not be punished for it. Sorry, I should say, if I go a different way, I should not be punished by making the way back slope-based and spamming cacos. Bad. Bad. Do not like. That was the first... But whatever, I guess we can restart the map. Yeah, and the jumping is now. I mean, for all I know, that was an optional area. So, we start again. You now have mouse walk, crouch, and... Yeah, that's a glitch. That's a... I don't know how the hell you do that, but... The waterfall has an effect on it. Some description. Anyway, we'll just not go that way and ignore it. Maybe we'll find a way where I can start blazing through parts of this map or something. It asked that you go the wrong direction once and that's it, you're dead. Sorry, I couldn't be bothered balancing every route out, so just die and go over again. We'll have to see if it still persists, this problem of... Hey, serious Kekademon, how's it going? I just started to sense there might be a small problem with ammo distribution once the level starts. Well, I could be wrong. This might be further evidence of why people shouldn't start in Xenu, maybe. That old argument. You're dead. And so are you. How goes it, Sirius? I'm surprised that's not a secret. It's apparently not a secret. 12 3D doors aren't available in software render. They do. Oh, I just noticed there's actually a key down there. I assume I'm gonna have to get there. One would guess this key looks pretty mandatory. Well, we have a green. Oh, we have a green key card, but it doesn't show up on the UI. Oh, what? Are you kidding me? I have to run all the way back through the fucking slimeage? And the armor is a secret. Wow, he hit the first real armor pickup underneath the bridge. Okay, now how am I getting out of this? Is there a way back up to the top of the platform? Because you can need to provide those if you're going to tell the player to go down to get a keycard that doesn't show up on the UI for some reason. Hey, seriously. So that's the exit. I think this is the way back. I could have just been a lift there. Going around all this just to drop off once. Oof. Well, at least he can get back. I don't know if that's a more... Couldn't it have been easier just to have a lift there? Thus negating the whole need for that? I'm starting to get the impression this reminds me of... That's the plus key, John. Plus key. Do it. Oh, right. No, it doesn't even show up on the enhanced view thing. I mean, usually the keys like that usually go in the key slots anyway. They don't usually disappear. So he has a green key card that's invisible on the HUD. And I can jump there. Oh, whoa! I just skipped the entire level. I like these explosions for revealing the open areas there. Yeah, you can actually skip the entire level by jumping over the first platform. And keep in mind, this does encourage jumping, so I'm not cheating. But that's jumpable, so... There's your next problem. Level that can be easily bypassed. The jump. If For the sake of the test, however, we won't do that. We will continue as normal. So I'm kind of curious to see what the rest of the level's like. But yeah, this looks like someone who was testing in... This again looks like someone who's just testing out the usage of Zaydoon features and stuff. But as I've said before, you can't carry a map just by using fancy... Whoa, what's with the lighting? Weird shadows too. This entire floor, in fact. You still have to have a good map behind all your fancy Zaydoon effects. At some point I'm still getting around to playtesting your Swarter map, MTX, so... Still what my to-do is at some point, but I'll play another few hours. Oh, there's not a pain elemental attached to these lost souls. I don't think there is. Fucking cack it even though. There seems to be sort of a... It feels like... I don't know. It just feels a bit odd that if you're gonna have this sort of open approach where you can climb on stuff, not to punish the player for taking one route like I did earlier. Where are we now? Oh. So with which should we come on a giant archway? That was the entire purpose of that. Was to go on a giant archway. Get to back to this point again. Well, my goal now is to... Get the chain gun finally. And this time we actually have armor. You still haven't finished it. As a weight cargo somewhere on the far side of the moon. Well, having this armor will help, I think, in beating the level. I'm going that way. Whoa! Triple cargo swarm much. Imp over there. Oh, Jesus Christ, there's another two of them? How many cacos do you fucking want, man? You're not giving a lot of ammo for all this. I go by the bell. Talk about lack of generosity on ammo, to some extent. Also need to slow your character down a bit. Ugh. Oh my god, another gecko. Looks like it gives just enough. Looks like you get just enough ammo, but only if you follow the correct route. This one. Don't you dare deviate from that route, or else you are screwed. It would seem. Don't be going down any of those fancy tunnels I've heard about. They will wreck your ship. God, alright. I mean, I guess this is obviously still a work in progress, but these are the things that illuknisaa needs to work on. Wow, I should have gained no health benefit there. Ugh. Ooh. Green glowing walls. A freaky light power thing. Oh no, I jumped in his head. Huh. This is a very unusual staircase. Very unusual staircase. A staircase of tubes. Among other things. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Oh no. I hear a pain elemental. Where? Oh, there he is. Please disappear. Lost. Kind of cool I used that as a passage forward. I need to jump onto the forklift. Area is pointless. I can't really see much else to say about this so far. When I got the chainsaw, ambush followed soon after. I'm not exactly keen to start that up, certainly. At least not yet. Right, now I'll start up, I guess. Oh shit, I did not want to do that. Shit, now we have a problem. Am I able to get back up? Yeah, it looks like I can. Wait. Just barely. No, wait, how am I getting back? This doesn't seem good at all. Can't go lower, can I? Shit. Ugh, what is with these ways back? They're so complicated. Jump there or something? It actually looks like he wants me to jump over on these little side things or something. But that can't be achieved. Oh, don't tell me it's so far back. Why has he got all these dumbass jumping areas? I need to jump over this way. I'm sick of these fucking jumping areas. Can we get it with it? We clear that platforming in Doom doesn't fucking work unless it's really well done? Okay. You want all this slope shit, fine, make it easy. This is the wrong way of doing all this. Where is this leading to? What am I supposed to be doing? What is the angle of trajectory? I'm supposed to go over there? The angle, and also the slope's giving me no momentum, so I can't actually make this jump, I don't think. No, this is just finicky precise bullshit, so... Whoops, I skipped it. Actually, it doesn't seem to matter because there's no point in going in this one even. That's pointless. So I'm supposed to go over here then instead? Like, make a huge leap over here? And then go back up or something? I can't even get up there though. Being very ambitious there. Ever anyway, by the sounds of it. What the fuck am I doing? So is this a dead end or what? Is this really a dead end? I can't get up there. I can't get back. Going over there doesn't do anything. What is the point of this area? What is the point of this little slope area if there's nothing? I can't seem to get over here. There's not enough momentum. Oh, there must be some other area I'm supposed to go to. I'm supposed to go down here and run for the fucking waterfall? Cross the fucking pond and jump on this platform? And then what? Jump on here? Well, then this leads to this stupid shit again. No. I don't want to be over here. So I'm just going to no-quit back up to where I want to be. What's the fucking point to this area? I'm just no-quipping back to an area I recognize, you know. You want pointless areas in your map, and I get to no-clip out one of them. Yeah, fine, I need a chainsaw. Whatever. Well, because I would like to have the chainsaw, man. Session, kill it! Kill it! Kill it with fire, or whatever. And no one dies. Okay. Now I can get over there. Is that what I'm supposed to do? Yes. So this entire area here. Yes, that is a neat idea for a trap. So what I'm saying is perfectly clear. All this area here is entirely pointless. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't have an enemy on it. It doesn't lead anywhere. Can't use it to get anywhere important. So it's a waste of an area. And now I'm gonna get back to trying to figure out where to go. Yeah, it's a pretty cool setup. You know, that's the that's using GZ Doom stuff in the good way, you know. You know, using it for cool shit. Now we have a blue key. We can move on somewhere. There seems to be a bit of sort of open-endedness to this, but... There's clearly also work to be done here as well. Ooh, I can get the goodies now. Am I going anywhere into the... Oh, I'm going the wrong way. The blue key thing is like on the other side. But hey, I'm going through. I need to be going back here. There's the blue key door. That I see. That's what I'm after. Okay. Oh, there's ammo. To make it to this point, you get shitloads. Huh. Cool. Music's changed again. Nice. See you later. Stupid cacko. Yep. So there's the sort of camera cut, whatever that feature's called. Nice little cutaway there. So the exit's open. So all that area down there is basically a really nasty, horrible, but not needed, optional area. What reward, though? The ammo is coming out, as are the mid-tier monsters. As are the revenant snipers. Boo! Yes. Yeah. Okay. I can ignore that rev, you know. Just saying. Ignore that too. I can also ignore these mancubuses. Can't ignore this one though. This one's kind of okay. Kill it. Why did that door have to fucking reopen? I appreciate that. No. I'm not saving here because... Oh, that's the end. I thought there was going to be one last trap there, actually. But, oh, that's it. That's the monster vocal, and that's the end of the test. Okay, then. So, what did you all think of illuknisaa's canyon.wad, which is a work in progress by him. I have previously playtested something by illuknisaa, and I don't remember what it was, but it was something. This seems like an experiment in using GZ Doom features to me. But it was passable gameplay. I'm not. That area with the canyons was just really nasty, and it's optional. And ignoring that area, the rest of this was just really ammo starred, except for maybe one or two areas. It didn't have a nice gameplay flow to it. It felt like one of those maps that was more about the detailing and the features than it was about having a good time, you know. And that's where people rightfully call out, you need to practice making good maps before you start using Zadoom stuff, you know, because a boring Zadoom map with all the features is really noticeable. It's like, okay, this fan's really cool, but your gameplay is dull. That wasn't very exciting. It's nice to see that he's using all these slopes and stuff, but I've played my share of boring Zadoom maps, and that was one of them. Interesting ideas, maybe, but it did not add up to an interesting map. You know, you've got to get the gameplay detailing balance right, especially if you're going to do Zadoom stuff. A few more textures would have been nice. There was a lot of basic texturing throughout the whole map. That canyon area didn't seem to have an obvious reward. And some of the slopes even seemed pointless. There were some pointless platform areas that didn't seem to have any real purpose of being there. You know, you could remove those. You know, simplify the level a little bit. You have your advanced features and wall crawling, fine. But get it for, like, secrets or something, not just... I mean, the fact that there's a point where armor is hidden under the bridge, and you have to go all the way around a stupid cliff just to get back to where you are, instead of taking what could have just been a simple little mini lift off to the side somewhere to get back to the bridge, illustrates the problems of this map perfectly. You know, design before gameplay. Cool. Platforming. That's my thoughts. By all means, I like the theme of the map, Canyon. Pretty neat. Gotta make it more interesting. To do that, you have to make the gameplay interesting. That's what I intend to do in my Hell map suite. Based on your reaction to it, I think I managed to do that quite well. Well, yes, you did. You managed to make the detailing of the map really good, but the gameplay was also pretty good. Well, you know, this was dull. Really dull, you know. There was exciting gameplay, you know, the sort of open-ended, you know, exploration-type level. But the fact that you could go through a ventilation, that entire canyon area is an evil area. You know, you got a pain element, you got cacodemons, you got slope jumping. If you have no ammo, that's pretty much a game over. I mean, he needs to put more ammo on the map. First thing, more ammo and health. You know, scattered through the level. So, it wouldn't take much to make it fun. Well, you'd have to make... It probably wouldn't, but you'd have to do a few things. It's a work in progress, but these are the things that needs to be worked on. Making it more fun. Enough of these features. Yes, you can make fans. Yes, you can make slopes. Yes, you can make cutscenes. Whatever. I don't care. I want to play a map that is fun to play. A lot of people who play Doom maps want a map that is fun to play. This is the problem that Zadoom maps have sometimes. They focus more on what they can get away with on a technical level than making the actual map enjoyable to play from the beginning, which is why people say you should practice with Boom first. But a credit to those that do use Zadoom features. Don't forget that you're doing your poly objects and your slopes and your cutscenes. Some people just want to shoot demons without having to deal with slopes and platforming. Alright, that's my little rant over. Those are my points. Please continue to work on it by all means. That's going to be my stream for tonight. So, time to thank some people. So, thank you, Amunjung, Cyanidium 531, Defy Hardcore, Fader Fader. I almost said hello to you, Ordinance Phil, when you came in. To that guy who made Winter's Fury, Sniffgriff, Starman 27, Techno Joy, This Dude, Turbo Far, good to see you again, Vordience. You've been around a little while now as a lurker, I think. So yeah, next time Doom-wise, apart from the fact I need to do mapping streams, I will be doing Ancient Aliens, and I plan to do a stream. I plan to do a stream on Friday night, which I like to think would be Ancient Aliens, first part of. So look forward to that. See you on Friday. Have a good evening.